Change the contents of the talk. Last week, I remind that the title of the conference it is the Miller symmetry and Gromfitt invariance. So I want to talk the results related to the Obi-Hold Gromfitt symmetry. So I'm sorry. Today I cannot speak about the Saito duality. So first, before I explaining the, my original motivation, I want to give the main result today. So first, I introduce the Dedekind's eta function. And here Q is e to the 2 pi I tau. And consider this eta product. And also the Fourier expansion of this. And C1 is 1, and C3 is 2, and C3 is 0, and C4 is 2, and so on. And so, do you know the geometric meaning of these Fourier coefficients? This is the, so what we did is to give or interpret these Fourier coefficients of this eta product. And so what we obtained is that these CIs are Obi-Fold Gromfitt invariants of Obi-Fold P1 with three isotropic points of order 3. And this is joint work with Ikuo Satake. So we obtained this result based on the mirror symmetry of hypersurface singularities, or especially mirror symmetry of simple elliptic singularity. Okay, so later I will give some rough sketch of proof. But before going to that, I want to explain my motivation. So this is in some sense a byproduct of the, my project on the mirror symmetry of singularities. So what I really want to understand is the following correspondence. So here I write discrete group, and here root system. And here, singularity. And it is well known that there are several mysterious and interesting dualities among them. So, for example, first one is the well-known Mackay correspondence. And in this case, here we have a polyhedral group. Groups, polyhedra. And here, classical or ADE root system, classical. Root system. And also here, ADE singularity. And the next one is the so-called Arnold's strange duality. And in this case here, we have Fuchsian groups. And And here, so-called 14 exceptional singularities. For example, here, for example, we have this E8 singularity. This is E8 case. And here, for example, we can consider this singularity. And also here, we have exceptional root system. So in this sense, this Arnold strange duality is a generalization of Mackay correspondence to more complicated singularities. Okay, so what I want to do is to understand this these correspondences by Miller's method. And also, the following is known. Corresponding to this, we have here. I'm sorry, I forgot. So first, and also, we should comment that there exist three constructions of cytostructure. It is called as a Frobenius manifold or Frobenius structure. And here we have Gromfittian theory. And here Saito's original theory of primitive forms. And here the construction by invariant theory. Of wild groups. And this correspondence is known as classical Miller symmetry. And also, I write another picture. So, also we have a similar correspondence in the in homological Miller symmetries. And here we have in the singularity setting. Here we have a category of a graded matrix factorization. And this should be a homological Miller symmetry dual to the derived category of directed Fukaya category of the singularity. And here we have another one, the derived category of the representations of quivers with relation. And so far, I've been interested in these correspondences and also these correspondences and studied this for many singularities. But today, and also from this correspondence, we can explain these But today I omitted that part. And today, so I want to explain this correspondence for the simple elliptic singularities. And so in order to make more precise, we have to introduce some terminology, so I'll explain. So first, notation setting. So first, our initial data is weighted homogeneous polynomial. So weighted homogeneous polynomial in n variables, but later I'll consider only the case when n is 2, n is 3. And so in order to consider the mirror symmetry of singularities or weighted homogeneous polynomial, we usually assume that F is invertible. This means F is sum of the following monomials, so I, J, AI, X, XJ, some K, IJ, and KIJ is some integer. So, for example, a typical example is the Fermat type. So, for example, x1 k1 plus xn kn, for example. And also, there are two other types. So, chain and loop. And this is, for example, k. And here, okay. So, so usually we consider the polynomial which is the sum of these three classes of polynomial. And so if we consider this invertible polynomial, then we can consider the transpose, or more precise, Bell-Gruen Hurwitz transpose of F. And this is given by using this this matrix. So in this case, this F is given by xj kji. So here, this is a transpose of this this matrix. Okay, so in this sense, this is invariant. So the transpose of Fermat type is the original one. But if you consider this case for chain, so we have in this case we have transpose of F is x two x one to k one. X3, X2, K2, plus X3, K3. Yes? For simplicity, I'm sorry. So you can generalize very easily. So. And by using this, we can consider the mirror symmetry of singularity with some group, symmetry group of F. Okay, so I'll explain. So here I write A as a conjecture, mirror conjectures. So first, I want to explain in the classical setting. So well, for simplicity, I write it in this way: F J R W D G is M is I to F Z. This is. So by this I want to mean that the so there is a construction of cytostructure or Frobenius structure by Fang, Jarvis, Ruan, Whittle. So this I want to mean the cyto or Frobenius structure associated to this constructed from FJRW a model for T, F, and G. So, and here G is a maximal abelian symmetry group acting diagonally on F of F for simplicity. Or the this. And here right in the right hand side this is Frobenius structure from the theorem of primitive form.
Question.
We know
the choice of primitive form is not unique.
Yes. So yes. Good question. So this by so in order to the. I mean the choice of primitive form I put here zero. So by this I want to mean choose the choice of the primitive form corresponding to the origin. Or the origin means the this is the Landau-Ginzburg point in the Basel deformation space, or the point corresponding to this F, or the choice of opposite filtration corresponding to the original polynomial. Okay, so the choice that such a choice defines a unique primitive form up to constant, so it defines a flat or Frobenius structure. So by this, I'm going to mean that's Frobenius structure. And the first mirror conjecture is the classical one is this one. And this is known for AD singularity case. So I should write. First, I should remark. So this is if one, this one is known for AD singularity. This is by Fan Jarvi and Wu. So we want to consider the next case, next step. So I forgot to explain the about the hierarchy of singularities. So in three variables. So if n is three, the simplest singularity is the AD singularities. For example, you have this singularities, and the next one is the simple elliptic singularities. And in this case, this five will be six. And the next case is 14 exceptional singularities. And so on. And if you go down, then the problem becomes much harder and harder, difficult. Okay. And also this should contain so-called topological mirror symmetry. And by this, I want to mean there is some, or before Poincaré polynomial, and one may consider this conjecture. And this is essentially checked by Kravitz up to some technical point. And now with Fang, we want to have this topological mirror symmetry from the Hodge's theoretical point of view. So it's very technical, but I should comment one thing. So here, he defined a bigraded structure by hand, or he introduced bigraded structure. But what we want to do is to obtain or to derive from the Hodge theory of singularity. And so here this is anyway, I'll skip that. Anyway, so we are now trying to understand this this correspondence from the Hodge theoretical point. Okay. So and so this is one. So for. This is a very interesting conjecture for simple elliptic singularity. But today, I want to consider a little bit different one. So, related by the so-called Carabiel-Landau-Ginzburg correspondence. So I'll explain later. So, before I want to explain the homological version, homological mirror symmetry version. So, in this case, I write just in a simple way. So uh, I don't want to explain this in detail, but this is the homological mirror symmetry version of this for the singularity with group action. Okay, so here L is some extension of G, the same G, by Z. Okay. And here we consider the L-graded version of the category of matrix factorization. And also, so this is not is known for ADE and simple simple elliptic singularity. This is done by, for example, I list the name of people who side Weda and Kajura. Okay, so in this setting, the problem is now to understand this for Arnold's 14 exceptional singularities. Okay. Yes?
So for the second equivalent, where the quiver process is
happening? This one?
Yeah, the
middle
one. What is the middle one?
Middle one. The quiver, we can choose many quivers, so it is not canonical.
Oh, it's not a quiver term that you can ask.
Sorry. So, how to say? For example, so for AD singularity, uh-huh. there is a good choice, uh-huh. the usual one. Right. And also, for simple elliptic singularities, we have some good one, but we don't have a method to choose a good one, or how to say, we don't have the definition of the good quiver. So of course, so you can by mutations of exceptional collection, you can choose different quiver with relations. So it is not canonically obtained from F or this. But anyway, so by the existence of the strongly exceptional collection, then at least we can show that there exists a quiver with relations for some singularities.
Does a high category always have a strong exceptional
collection? So if at least, if F is F can be reduced to the curve singularities, or F is stable equivalent to the curve singularity, then this always has a strongly exceptional collection. But in general, we don't know. Anyway, so for some good singularities, we have this. And next step is to generalize this to the more complicated singularities. And as a sub-conjecture of this, we have some generalization of Arnold's strange duality. And recently, with Wolfgang Ebeling, we are now studying the generalization of Arnold's strange duality for exceptional bimodal singularities. And originally, I wanted to explain that story today, but I changed the content. So there, we can discuss the relationship between these mirror symmetries and the Saito's duality of the characteristic polynomial of Milner monodromy. It is also very interesting, but I'm sorry, today I cannot explain. Okay, so the main point is the next one. So, but in the simple, so from now, I want to concentrate in the simple elliptic singularities. So from now, I want to consider the case when F is simple elliptic singularity. So this is classified in the following three types. So three, 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 and two, four, four, and two, six. And it is called E611 type and E711 type. And this is called E811 type. And to each singularity, I'll attach the tuple of integers. In this case, 3, 3, 3, and 2, 4, 4, and 2, 3, 6. And in this case, in the in this picture, we have a very interesting triangulated equivalence. So in this case, a category of L-graded matrix factorizations is equivalent to the derived category of coherent sheaves on P1A. So by P1A, I want to mean the orbifold P1 with three isotropic points of order A with the isotropic points associated to A. So, and also, these three singularities has a moduli. So, one parameter with degree zero. So, we can consider the family of these simple elliptic singularities. And this triangulated equivalence is, in some sense, related to the choice of parameter. I don't discuss in detail, but so because of this equivalence, I can consider the variant of this for only for this case. So in this case, we consider the orbifold Gudmundsen theory for P1 orbifold should be isomorphic to the Saito's. I'm sorry. And Gudmundsen theory of P1A is isomorphic to the here Saito's F. And here the choice of primitive form is at infinity. And this is also equivalent to the wild group invariant theory associated to A or elliptic root system. From this is from elliptic root system. And here, this is some from Orbifold Gromov-Chain theory on P1. And here, in the choice of primitive form, is the how to say corresponding to the infinity, or the corresponding to the opposite filtration to the Hodge filtration coming from the maximally unipotent monodromy point. So so this is a variant of the first conjecture. And the theorem is that I, this is true. And also, we have another one. Gromov-Chain theory of P1 orbifold with four isotropic points with order 2 is isomorphic to the one from the elliptic root system of type D411. And so this is our main theorem. Yes?
Of course, you can think of P1 as a combination of mirror symmetry produced with the line of interval, Calabria.
Yes, in some sense. So, I should remark here. So, the correspondence between F infinity and M F0 is related to Calabi-Landau-Ginzburg correspondence. So in this sense, so this and this the correspondence between this understood this correspondence very well, then we get the Calabi-Landau-Ginzburg correspondence. Okay, so now I want to explain a sketch of proof of the theorem and. Also, I want to explain application or the first result. Okay, so I want to start from the simplest case, this case, as a warming up. So in this case, P1, 2, 2, 2, 2. D4 1-1 case. So first we want to consider this. So in this case, orbifold cohomology of P1 2-2-2-2 this is a six-dimensional and it's zero. Is a one-dimensional.
Can I ask you one question?
Yes.
So, what is the representation of P1?
I'm sorry, I forgot to explain. So, this one, very roughly speaking, P1 with four isotropic points of order 2. So here you have...
this? Abstractly.
We have some algebra geometrical description, but we don't need it today. No. H2 1 and. these two, H0 and H2 term come from the usual cohomology. And we have a four-dimensional twisted sector. And it is of degree half. And in order to describe the Frobenius or Gromov-Witten potential, I want to introduce coordinates. I want to flat coordinates. T0, T or log Q. And here, T1, T2, T3, T4. Then one can easily show that the Gromov-Witten potential, a genus zero Gromov-Witten potential, must be of the following form. So first, 2 plus 4. T0, T1. And this is these are classical terms. And so now we are considering the O before the P1. So here, the value of non-degenerate bilinear form is half in this case. So we put as an initial condition, one of the initial condition. Okay, so these are classical terms. And from now, we have quantum correction part. Five terms obtained by permutation. And also here we have T4. Okay, so we have this quantum correction term. And the most the key is that there exists a unique solution of the WDBB equation for F. Or so if you consider the Frobenius structure with these flat coordinates of suitable degrees and this potential. Then, together with the these conditions, F0, Ai, Qi. You have a unique solution. We can show you that there is a unique solution of this. So first, we can show that the uniqueness of the Frobenius structure. And
if more than F2 start from power 0.
But yes. And indeed, F2, I'll write down the explicit explicitly later. But anyway, first we have this. And in this case, In the Gromfitton theory case, we obtain this from geometry. So this part corresponds to the map of degree 1 from this orbifold to this. And the number of this is, this is 1, just an identity. So as in the quantum cohomology of P2, we have enough initial data to determine the Gromfitton zero Gromfitton potential. So from this, so our assumption is that these classical terms, so this is part of initial data. And I think this is very natural. And also, this is also initial data. Then we can uniquely determine, we can obtain the genus zero Gromfitton potential. But now, these F0 and F1 and F2 are formal power series in Q. But by the uniqueness of the solution, we can compare the the potential from the D411 compare with. Then we can write down these F0, F1, and F2 very explicitly. So first I write the answer. So first I put first I want to introduce another function. So FQ, this is essentially the Eisenstein E2. And this is minus Q dQ log E to tau. And by this function, we can explicitly write down this. So by using this F0, Q is the odd part of this function, odd degree part of this. So FQ minus F minus Q, and F1Q is, this is a little bit technical, but FQ minus F0Q minus FQ to 4. And F2Q is 6 times FQ to 4. So, very roughly speaking, this Gromfitton potential is written by the KSI modular form. And also, we have the geometric interpretation of this result. So, so we are considering the holomorphic maps from this orbifold to this. But this P1222 is the orbifold of the elliptic curve by the simplest involution. So we can easily relate to the counting problem of elliptic curves with marked point, four marked points. Okay, so these four points will go to four isotropic points. And this holomorphic map should be compatible with this holomorphic map. And so this is the reason why we have this function. And so I think many people here knows very well about this function. This is a genus one potential of the elliptic curve. Okay, so this picture naturally explains the meaning of these functions up to these combinatorial factors. Okay, so for example, this part corresponds to the map. Four marked points. F2 corresponds to four marked point goes to one orbifold one point, and F1 goes to four points to 2 points, and F0 corresponds to four marked points go to 4 points. Okay, so this is explanation of this choice of functions. Okay. So so in this way we can understand this case, P1, 2, 2, 2, 2, orbifold case very well. Okay, so this is just a warming up. And second, the most next interesting case is E611. In this case, the proof is essentially the same. The uniqueness of solution of the WDVB equations and together with initial condition coming from the geometry. Okay. Anyway, I write some parts of the Gronfittian potential. First, here you have a classical term. So here we have three isotropic points of order 3. So to each a special point, we have two twisted sectors, those are written in by this these T11 and T12, for example. And these are classical terms, and here we put initial condition. And also from here, there are 14 terms with quantum correction. And the first one, T11, T21, T31, F0Q plus so on. So I wrote here the most two most important terms, and similarly we in this way we have 14 functions, formal parishes in Q. And the result is the following. First, F0Q. This is the main result I wrote here. First, this is given by x 9 tau cubed over e to the 3 tau. And f1 q is a q times f0 q. Here, a q is 1 plus so eta tau eta tau eta 9 tau 2 3 and FIQ determined all the power series are determined by F0 and this A. And the important part, so this is the answer to the first problem. And this A is related to the modulus of elliptic curves. So this A appears in the deformation of elliptic curves. So in this sense, so first, so I wrote here the correspondence between a cyto F infinity. So so first this A is obtained as the we choose the primitive form at the infinity, then we have the flat coordinate. Then by using the flat, it is the, essentially the log of Q, this Q. And by using that flat coordinate, we can invert the function, and we get the A as a function of the flat coordinate. So this is this AQ. Yes, Miramar. So usually a cubed is used in the Miramar, but here we consider the third root of the Miramar. Okay, so by some calculations we get this formula, and by using this AQ, this is also 1 minus a cubed q dq a. So in this way, you can express these fi's by in terms of a. And by this mirror map, we can relate these two. Oh, but I'm sorry, I forgot to comment. But this expression, of course, coming from this expression. So the similarity to the D411 case, first we show the uniqueness of the solution, and then compare these two. Okay, but the point is that this the flat structure. Is corresponding to the one here with the primitive form at the infinity, and this correspondence is classically known by Saito and Sasaki. So by using this triangle, we can obtain this. Okay. And we can continue this procedure to E7 case, E8 case. But the problem is that E7 case, we have more than 50 terms and is 8 case about 200 tons. So the problem is that we don't have a conceptual proof of these isomorphisms. So now we are looking for more sophisticated proof. But anyway, by calculation, we can show that show this correspondence for simple elliptic singularity. Because in these classes, we don't have a parameter with negative degree. So essentially, WDBB equation is powerful enough to recover all information. Okay, I finish here. Thank you very much.